I had a wonderful discussion with Frederick the other day on phone. And especially when both people, of us at the time, haven't really met with each other, and they have got different backgrounds and different perspectives. You know, a lot of ideation can happen, and two things occurred at that day, which I would like to present as the issues. Maybe they are important, maybe they are not so important, but this arose from what participation I saw on Konkani Wiktionary, which I just recently joined as a member on WhatsApp, and secondly from what I learned during about a particular project called Wiki Abstract and Wiki Lambda during my process of this candidacy. So let me first talk about the Konkani Wiktionary part. There was a very good observation made by a member that in Wiktionary, we are encouraging people to give the words of the particular dialect. Unlike many other languages, Konkani has got a large number of dialects. It's spoken by people on a broad swath of the West Coast and even to the interiors, from parts of Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, and into Kerala. It's also spoken by religious communities, Hindu, Christian, Muslim. It's spoken by people who are of different ethnicities as well. And it's written in 5 different scripts. And with these kind of diversity, the Wiktionary and the Goan community has come up with a very broad and inclusive sort of a policy towards the language, embracing everything as our own. And I think that's so wise. And that's such a wonderful thought. And I'm really like to, express my appreciation to all those who thought of it, and who, and every one of you for having such a big heart to encase, all the things, so that, small differences in the way we speak or what script we write or where we belong should not divide this whole thing. So, but the point which comes from the Wikimedia point of view is that in Wikimedia, you have got certain principles like verifiability and no original research and that sort of thing. So if you consider these are called as pillars of Wikipedia: verifiability, no original research. Verifiability means you have to give a citation to something which has been published by a reliable source. Now, if we follow these two things very Calvinistically or very strictly, then what's going to happen is we can only enter words which have been published in public dictionary or Konkani dictionaries or any kinds of works, and for every entry we would have to give a citation. That is going to cripple this, because I'm sure that maybe for the one Konkani part there would be things. But I'm not so sure for any of the other dialects whether there are published dictionaries. There may be for one or two dialects more, but it's definitely not universal. And as a result of which, that would, generally kill the inclusivity as well as not be in the interest of the community or the language. Now, so my point came is that tomorrow, if someone raises an objection, and points it out as a community that you are violating Wikimedia values, core values. So however, Wikimedia has got other values as well. One of them is be bold. And second thing is consensus. So I felt that as a Goan community, or rather as a Konkani community, at the moment we'll keep out the other language, Goan language, missing and concentrate on the Konkani community, you should have some kind of a document prepared which states this inclusivity and why it has been taken. Put it up on the village pump of Konkani Wikipedia and have community to give their comments and approve it like that. So that if someone turns right around, you can say, yes, this issue was was brought up, it was discussed, a proposal was made, the community has endorsed. And in our Wikimedia community, that gives morally and legally standing to having that policy. Without it, you know, we can, if someone asks, we can say yes, community has taken a choice, they've taken a stand, they've considered the pros and the cons, and they've come up with this, and this is it. And then afterwards, if you feel that this is wrong, engage in a discussion with us, and then we'll see. So the point is, nobody gets a chance to, you know, come and directly to, you know, enforce anything on us. So our values, key values of inclusivity, which is such a wonderful value, gets protected. So this was one point of view which came up, and I would like to thank Frederick, because it was in our discussion this issue came up. So the credit for this is as much his as mine. Would anyone like to give their opinion on this? Because this is, at this point of time, this is just a nascent thing which is being thrown around. There must be other issues, there must be other perspectives. Maybe it's a bad idea, I don't know.
Ashwin, if you could just take us forward to Wiki Lambda, because that is critical. Then we have a lot of time for discussion. There's not an issue.
The second thing which struck me is that, the foundation has actually been working in a very nice way, technically way, forward way, towards pushing Wikipedia and open knowledge needs for the 21st century. And one of the projects is been made by a gentleman called Denny Branchovic, who's employed by Google, but is also employed by the foundation. The Google has a policy wherein part of your spare time you can work for some other thing, project and all. And he was the man who created Wikidata as part of the German community. So Wikidata is a place where, you know, all data is linked. That means if there is a article, in the knowledge world or in the library cataloging world, you have got objects and you have got a concept of entity. That means, suppose I've got a collection of 1,000 books and I want to map this content. So, and I've got the whole world of knowledge. So then I pick spots in the world of knowledge, give them names, like I say kings. So I'll say this king, that king, this, and then that becomes, that phrase that I choose becomes an index word or a cataloging word. And then all the books which contain mention of that king, I give it. So using these terms, we can create a network of knowledge, these things, and create a list of these catalog words. And in the cataloging world, the library world, it's called an authority list. So these authority lists are an alternate level above the actual catalogs or indexings, no matter whether it's online, whether it's Wikipedia, or whether it is any catalog which is in your this thing, or even something which you make at home. If you give it catalog words, all these words exist in the knowledge space, and you are mapping links between the knowledge space and the objects that you have which you are being cataloged. And you can have those relationships where one object is connected to one word, one object is connected to many words, one word is connected, you know, to many objects, and that sort of thing. So Wikidata is really, really good at this, and it's open. So you can connect it and use this data to find, you know, any collection outside the world also. And the wonderful thing about it is it's created in such a way that you can, it's, you're using a particular style of computer language. I think Tanmay is the tech guy, he'll be able to explain it better. I'm saying it very simply, like a 4G, so that we understand. Using that particular language or that particular grammar, you can make queries. Like you can say, please tell me the names of all the presidents of India who are from Maharashtra and died after 1975. Or you can say, please give me the list of all sportswomen of India who have won international medals and who are above the age of 20. Something of that. So you can make these queries based on what information you have. Now these kind of queries of knowledge are impossible to get as far as this thing is concerned, and this is called Wikidata. This project exists. A lot of us have participated in one way or the other, and I'm sure that Tanmay will be able to tell you more about it in some other event. Now the Wikidata, the chief architect of this was this Denny guy, and they came up with another project which has got 2-3 names. It's called, in one level it's called Wiki Functions, another place it's called Wiki Lambda, and our third name is Abstract Wikipedia. But basically it talks about one concept only. This concept is that you got Wikipedia, and this Wikipedia is basically, sets of statement giving various facts, and in that set of papers there is language, and they are telling relationships between various objects. So you can take this any language and reduce it to a set of facts and relationships and grammar constructs and construct a computer language which expresses that. And you can write a general purpose computer language which expresses all the relations in the world, so that no matter which language you have, that there the fact will be there on Wikidata, and the relations also will be there. And if you that you can take statement from any Wikipedia in any language, and you can represent it as a line of computer code. Now all this may sound very abstract, but what's the aim of these people? The aim of these people is to map all the languages in the world, and then afterwards have the ability to take knowledge and construct, or take any Wikipedia article, translate it from the human language, say English, convert it into that computer language, Wiki Functions or Wiki Lambda or whatever. And then once you converted it, using the relationship, the way that you converted from English to Wiki Lambda, you can convert it back. Same way, if you map for every other language, with this one computer code, you can generate a full-fledged Wikipedia article just through computer, that is through artificial intelligence or computer processing or whatever you want to call it, and produce a ready-made article in every language. Now, this has got a number of ramifications, and we need to think about this. The first ramification is that this can't progress unless the language is translated into computerese. So for that they need the list of words and the grammatical relationships and the pronunciation and all the ways it is used in grammar. So it is something like a Wiktionary, but not exactly a Wiktionary article. It was something which was told to me very recently by Tito Datta, who is the program director of the SIS A2K, and he is explaining to me how Bengali Wikipedia is doing it, and there are 2-3 other Wikipedias also, I think Malayalam and Marathi are doing it in India. And the particular unit is like in Wiktionary, we are discussing about a word, but in this case, for the purposes of Wiki Lambda, it's called as a lexeme. So you create pages about this lexeme, one page per lexeme. And these lexemes are words or concepts or pieces of grammar. And there are a lot of attributes which you can write, and it takes a lot of thinking. Probably it requires some amount of academic people who are learned about the language to contribute. But it's a one-time process. And the moment you've done it and you improved it and checked it and done that, after that, Konkani will be translatable into computerese and vice versa, and then that material which is contained in the Konkani article can be translated into any language in the world, and vice versa. Suppose there was a you want a particular language or article in Konkani to be transferred into any other language, you can do that. So the communities which do the work as far as the lexeme preparation are there can reap the benefits. What are the benefits? For example, now Konkani Wikipedia has got maybe say, I don't know, how many articles does it have at the moment?
Roughly? 3,500.
So 3,500. And it's going to take time to come up to the next level, say 35,000 or 50,000 and 1 lakh and all. But it will still be far behind, because English Wikipedia is something like 6.4 million articles or something like some big figure like that. So there is never going to be a situation where you will have a Konkani article on almost everything on earth. But if you do this Lexeme work, and these people are going to progress with their knowledge, it's like a steamroller, you know, it's like a road roller. It's very slow, but unstoppable. And afterwards, those communities which don't do the Lexeme work, they are going to be disadvantaged. They'll be on the other side of the digital divide. And now the digital divide will become a knowledge divide. And those who have done the Lexeme work will be on the this side, where the actually the sum of human knowledge, say represented in English Wikipedia and all the Wikipedias in the world, can be translated into any one language. If you want to do it, you know, and a huge dump of 6.5 million articles in Konkani, fine. Otherwise, you can do it on demand also, that only those articles that people request, it's done on the fly and given to you. That can be done. But there's a downside. The first downside is that this whole movement is about humans, humans participating, humans caring, humans having culture, humans collaborating, humans creating, crafting, you know, articles, you know, literary works, and contributing and sharing, and also it's all about humanity and human values. The future after that is ideal for Wikipedia to turn into some kind of Google, where you and me and community are no longer important, and our particular contributions will not be, you know, as good as maybe what the computer generates. And you know, we get like the worker in the automated factories, we get, you know, reduced to people who are, you know, subordinate to the whole process and other things. So there is a 1984 type dystopian sort of a aspect also to this vision. At the same time, there is a threat that if we don't get involved with this, you will be left out, you know, in the poorest of your, in the dispossessed, in the voiceless people, in the knowledgeless people of the world, in that sense. And this quandary or dilemma will face every nation or every language community in the world. And I don't know whether anyone has you know, thought of these aspects or not. This aspect came up in the discussion between me and Tito Datta. So while we were ideating on this issue. So this is something which I thought I must mention to the Goan community, so that you all can think in your minds about all these things, and you know, work out for yourselves. Is this good? Is this bad? Is this something you should go forward? Is this something you should support? Is it something to be neutral? Would you like to postpone this activity? Would you like to be forward and push this in the first place? And that sort of thing. There are a huge number of questions which come. What about the richness of our dialects? What about this? Will you have a separate Lexemes for dialects? You know, all kinds of ramifications are there, and nuances will be there. And a lot of these will affect the way that we as humans think and work and contribute. So this is the issue which I thought I'll tell you. So this was my second point of the day regarding languages. And Frederick, from my side, I'm done. I've simplified this issue so much so that it's possible that I got a little one aspect wrong. If somebody you know, can enlighten me what I got wrong, I'll be really happy, because I'm fairly tech savvy, but I'm not a tech person myself in that sense. But I've tried to, you know, tell it like a story, like to simplify it, so that at least the, you know, the issue as it stands comes up, and we are all able to understand what it is, so that we can start beginning and increasing our knowledge on it and all the other complexities of this issue, because it's not a simple issue at all. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Ashwin. Really useful and good information. Now it's open house. Anyone can start and go on. We can go on till any time, maybe till midnight or whenever we get tired, whichever comes first.
Hi Ashwin, Tanmay here.
Hi Tanmay.
So I'm sure a little bit of the lambda part, some of it was quite technical also. So I'm sure, and some of it is for a little bit of people who are experienced with both Wikimedia and Wikidata. So if it's okay, I would just and I also would like to clarify on some points since you did mention.
Yes, please do that.
So is it okay if I just share my screen and then walk the rest of the audience along, and then you can correct me if I'm going wrong anyway.
Oh, fine, absolutely. Go ahead.
Okay, just give me 1 second. Yes. Oh yes, audience members, you can choose a 3-dot setting in your middle and choose spotlight mode. So that would put my screen on top instead of anything else. I'll switch off my camera also. Is my screen visible? Can you see Virender Sehwal?
Yes, I can.
And now can you see Shah Rukh Khan?
Yes.
Okay. So, okay. So this is Wikipedia, English Wikipedia. I've taken the starting. And right now, this is the Wikipedia article for Shah Rukh Khan, and this is for Virender Sehwal. Okay. And the third one I chose is Dilip Kumar. So I've chosen 3 examples. So first thing that you mentioned was about authority control, right? Which is down here. So these are all the different links to all the libraries and general sites around the world. So WorldCat is one. So this is the WorldCat identity for Shah Rukh Khan.
It's not so traveled down. It's still stuck on Dilip Kumar as far as I'm seeing.
Okay. Is it stuck for everyone?
Yeah. Now it's come.
Okay. So this is Goa and internet is always an issue. Electricity also might be. So in case I just drop off, please excuse. Yeah. So here, right at the bottom of the Shah Rukh Khan article is something called authority control, and this has the link to WorldCat and all other things that you mentioned, right? Hello.
Yes. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Right. And this is WorldCat, for example. So WorldCat has its own definition for Shah Rukh Khan. So it says, okay, he was born in 65, and all these other things. Most widely named. And this
that's the standard format for a person, huh? That means it tells the surname first and the name and the lifespan. That's the standard format for library cataloging along multiple, protocols.
Protocols, okay. And then on the side of the page, in the left corner here, there is something called Wikidata item. So the Wikidata item for Shah Rukh Khan has his description first in English. So it says, okay, his name is Shah. The name of the label can be whether a movie or a person. I've taken 3 people, keep it simple. So the Shah Rukh Khan, it says, okay, his description is he's an Indian actor, producer, and television personality, and also known as all these names of his. The same thing then translated into Hindi, Bharatiya film abhineta, King Khan, and there will be more. These are just the 4 top ones that it is showing. And then what is happening in Wikidata is all this data about Shah Rukh Khan is nicely logged and kept. But okay, he's an instance of a human, meaning this is a person that we are talking about. His sex or gender is male. This is one nice photo of him. A bit outdated, but yes, it's a photo of him. And citizenship India. His name is Jeevan name is Shah Rukh, his family name is Khan, date of birth. And right down at the bottom, if you scroll, are all those IDs, right? So VAIF, which one we chose? WorldCat. WorldCat will also be there somewhere. Here is WorldCat. So WorldCat will be stored, and this is how it translates into the thing that I mentioned at the bottom of the page. Okay, this is, if you list it here in Wikidata, it translates into authority control, right?
That means you can jump back and forth through all the different sets of these data about Shah Rukh Khan.
Right. Through the authority control, right. So these are all different sets of data about Shah Rukh Khan, and you can jump between them. Correct. We would have liked to see something similar on WorldCat that redirects you to Wikipedia. but okay, Wikipedia is offering you this. And now you're saying that once we have all this data in the structured format like this, we will use, so yes, these are all the different, just one thing, let me admit the new person who's joining. Yes, it's good. Okay. I not fine. There is Chrome is giving me issues.
Meanwhile, just interruption for half a minute. While the tech talks are going on, I think the newbies should not feel intimidated by...
That's my intention. Clarify it for the newbies.
So it's an intermediate or higher level discussion, but there are many different levels where all of us can get involved. So this is the technical side. Don't worry about it.
I can't find where is my Chrome with the this thing. With you guys on it, so this is the problem with
would you like to continue without presentation also?
Yeah. So to clarify, that you are saying that once we have it all in wiki data, then we write the lexemes in wiki lambda and it will translate this wiki data information into rough pages about that person. So it will say, okay, Shah Rukh Khan is a person, we have his data as actor, and I was going to show Dilip Kumar, which was going to show that he was an actor and he was a member of parliament from 2001 to 2006. And then this all data will get translated into the language that we want, the natural language that we want, so in this case Kokani, and which dialect of Kokani we choose, and it will get generated.
So then the Wikipedia output will not be the Konkani human output. It will be a separate, Wiki Lambda, Konkani, Wikipedia, or whatever you want to call it. And in that, there will be a page in Konkani Wiki Lambda Wikipedia, which will have about Shah Rukh Khan. But everything here about Shah Rukh Khan will not be by someone came and created an article and added the information. It will be based on what Tanmay showed us, which is there in that Wikidata entry. And all the rules of the wiki lexeme, which have been provided by the community, to so that they can connect it in as normal Konkani language. And in this process, the humans, after providing the the wiki data and the wiki lambda and writing the program, are then excluded.
Okay. So it will pick up from wiki data, correct?
Yeah, it can pick up from anywhere. The conceptually, it doesn't say that you have to pick up from Wikidata or something. The concept says that it takes objects and relationships and grammar type relationships and converts it into a particular language based on the lexeme information. So there will have to be like MediaWiki, some other program which does this work.
Okay.
That program is probably being written as of now. Or developed.
Okay. Yes, I noticed that all of this is still in a development stage. So yes, Virender Sehwag, if we see it lists out that he was a member of sports team, and which all teams also clearly listed. So Indian national team from 2001 to 2013, Delhi from 2014 to 1997 to start time, end time. Haryana, then Leicester City, County Cricket Club, all these. And awards also received. So, if I got a little bit more understanding then, that okay, basically it tries to pick up objects of this kind, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Ashwin, but if I understood right, some of this data can already be machine translated, but we are talking about full pages getting translated from across many languages if it's equipped, right?
See, conceptually, once you create this engine which deals you can even take literature or, you know, contracts or any material as input and convert it into a computer, you know, equivalent of a computer language equivalent, and then convert it into 50 different languages. That means if you got the Wikipedia Foundation's announcement of this election, instead of providing it in those 8 or 10 languages which they, you know, take the trouble of doing, you can put it in this engine and it will give you 320 and flash it on the Wikimedia Foundation, you know, that particular Wikipedia and the banner or something like that. So anything, it can be done, anything.
Okay, and so
it has also got a huge amount of value commercially. Just imagine, this is a foundation, this is research which they are pushing, and I really don't know as to the ownership pattern or this research which they are funding is being funded by someone else and who hold the patents and fixing it all. So this is not just something which is pushing the pattern of the, you know, technology for the future, which it is, but it's also a golden goose to come for the foundation. And we have seen how much the foundation is interested in the eggs that golden goose has laid.
Denzel, here, may I also try to explain a little bit about this?
Yeah, please. Who's speaking, please?
Denzel.
Okay.
Yeah, so let me share my screen.
Ashwin, while he shares the screen, just to clarify, like, even English sentences will get translated into Konkani automatically once this tool is up?
Any language that you have the lexemes for can be translated.
Okay.
That means we are only talking about 320 languages of world which are there with the Wikimedia, this thing, provided the lexemes are available. But it could well be every language in the world.
So we'll have to sit with the linguists of our language to get the lexemes, right?
I would suggest that you start speaking to those people who are already doing it in other communities, like Subodh Kulkarni in Marathi. I do not know who's doing it in Malayalam, and Tito Datta in Bengali. And you would get some direction to go about this. This is all Brave New World stuff. Huh? So even the foreign countries are, you know, they're just somewhere in the middle. They are just in the similar state to us. There are, you know, that Wiki Lambda or Knapsack Wikipedia. There are some pages on the project, and they got some statistics. Which language has given how many lexemes, or how many relations, or how many sound files? So each of these words also needs to be spoken out, and that sort of thing. So there is a spoken part also, which can be equally helpful in dictionary to you also.
So this is, again, correct me if I'm wrong, this is something for a long term, right?
Absolutely. But it's not going to take so long, and it's not a slow project in that sense. It's a medium paced project. It's a medium term project. It's not a long term project. It's a medium term project.
Okay.
Within 5 years, we'll see, you know, meaningful fruits. And 5 years is still a conservative answer. It could be as close as 2-3 years.
Okay.
This is just a judgment call. Huh? I have no figures or facts for these things which I'm throwing at you.
Correct, because what they're attempting is not is what everyone around the world has been trying for a long time also, a universal translator of sorts.
Very true. It's like one of those static devices, na? They where
right.
Hand, now you can speak Klingon.
Right. Denzel, yes, you can go ahead. I took too much of your time.
So basically, what they are trying to do is, okay, to generate, as Ashwin said, is to generate kind of an article on the fly. Okay. Now there are two components to this always. So the one component is called the abstract Wikipedia, and the other is called Wiki function. Okay. So what is abstract Wikipedia? So abstract Wikipedia will be a kind of a code. Now suppose I'm writing a paragraph on, say, Virendra Sehwag. Okay. So maybe just a couple of sentences. So I have to say that Virendra Sehwag, the data is now, for example, there in Wikidata. Okay. So Virendra Sehwag, human, cricketer, India. Okay. Virendra Sehwag, human, cricketer, India, and date of birth. Okay. This data is available. Okay. So this is the data which is available from the source. Now the abstract Wikipedia part of this will say that
make a sentence that tells in X language that Virender Sehwag is an Indian cricketer. He is, say, 50 years old, 45, whatever he is. Okay, these two sentences. Okay, so the instructions to make, you know, these are the two sentences which we want to form will be in the abstract Wikipedia. Okay, so in other words, the abstract Wikipedia tells the whole project or the system what needs to be there in a particular article. Okay, which sentences need to be there. Now the question is how to generate these sentences in a particular language. Okay, language X, like that can be Konkani or Odia or German or whatever language it is. That is encoded in wiki function. So you tell wiki functions that I want to make a sentence that says, that tells Virender Sehwag's nationality, profession and his age, two sentences. So wiki functions will say, okay, if you want to do it in Konkani, it is Virender Sehwag ek goenso ek Bharati cricket khyopi, like that, cricket khelpi, or whatever it is. Okay, in Hindi it is Virender Sehwag ek Bharatiya cricket ka khiladu hai, like that. Okay, so this will be stored in wiki function. And what needs to be there, go in the article by using the wiki function, is the abstract Wikipedia. Okay, does this make kind of sense now, Tanmay?
Right, okay.
Yeah. So now how it works. Will hold it. Is something like this. If you have a look at this image, now normally what happens is media.
These are all technical diagrams that will confuse everyone. I understood
So normally what happens is there is a server that has the pages, and you send a request to the server, the user sends a request to the server, and it loads a page for you saying this, I want the English Wikipedia article and we're in the server. And it loads a page which is already stored over there. Okay. Now what will happen with this abstract Wikipedia system is that, okay, the server does not have actual text. It has the abstract Wikipedia kind of instructions on how to generate an article, like what statements need to be there in the article. Okay. And how to generate that statements in X language is by the function, the wiki function. So the wiki functions will see, okay, this page needs to have these statements in this language. So okay, use the function. Generate the text, send it back, and then it will display then the server will display the text in that X language. So now the complicated thing is, of course, we can use the particular language and make that abstract Wikipedia, because we can say we want to have this one in the article, okay? But how to generate that for each language is very, very complex. And that is the wiki functions thing and wiki lambda. So wiki lambda is basically the extension that is the core of the wiki functions. So this is very complex, and you have to code how to say a particular statement in your language, and you can imagine it's complicated.
With your permission, Denzel, I'd like to present it as slightly more simple. I understood what you're saying, and I'd like to say it with my simple understanding, which I think will probably meet. Basically, facts are stored in Wikidata. Second thing is the words for each are stored, and the rules for grammar and other things, the words and the parts of the words, verbs, adjectives, things and all are stored in the lexemes that we made. Now, wiki functions or wiki lambda is basically the whole computer setup which takes this data, which takes these rules, and then you tell the program that what is it that you want to be told. I want to be told that that Virender Sehwag is an Indian cricketer who played cricket from this year to that year, and I want it to be told in Konkani. So then that program which has got wiki lambda and wiki functions in it will take data from Wikidata, and it'll take all the rules and the grammar from lexemes and join it together, and then output to you a statement in Konkani which says Sehwag to India's cricketer ashila and tanya hammers don dusra varsh tai cricket khel. That sort of thing. I hope my Konkani made sense to you.
Correct. I understood what you mean now. So action items for us would be to start working with linguists, right?
First.
Sorry? Go ahead.
I wanted to just say that abstract Wikipedia is actually the Wikipedia which is made like this artificial.
Correct. No, I was asking what would be our action items in the immediate future for Kokani.
At this point of time is basically understanding the issues. That is first, because until you understand, you don't know what's the particular course of action to do. And the second thing is that it's been clearly indicated by them that all the languages required to create this whole batch of lexemes for their particular language, which will help them to use their languages for at this point of time for development purposes to test out this whole project. So and I think a couple of Indian languages are also there in it. I don't recall at this point which are them, but probably one of them is Bengali. So but the truth is that when this project comes to fruit, all of us, every language will have to have created a me this lexeme. And since this is a Wikimedia project, that responsibility, I mean, prima facie comes to us, Konkani Wikimedians, for Konkani language. But there is nothing to say that this has to be an in-house affair. It's obvious none of us has the expertise to do this. So we will have to refer to experts. We'll have to get back to books and resources and try to do it in the best way possible. But the wonderful thing is, it's only a one-time job. Once it's done, then there's no other work after that. So it's a fixed job. It may be larger than we think, and it may be more difficult than we think, and it may be more involved and complicated than we think. But it's finite.
Correct. Rico is consistently telling us to move away from the tech topic, so just that's why I'll end this discussion here on Wiki Lambda. But yes, very interesting. Just that there's a lot of work to be done, as you said. Yes, that's a nice thing. Not frightening, just a lot to understand. And yes, as you said, there's a lot of work also to be done, whether to even support them at this stage or even once they launch to convert their abstract Wikipedia into Kokani.
That's why I was bringing out this issue, that this choice cannot be taken lightly, and maybe it's not even a choice which is for us only as a Wikimedia community. Maybe it's a choice for the broader community, that if you don't do it, you'll be on the wrong side of the digital divide, and if you do it, you'll be involved with all the issues which are going to come. So it's like a double-edged sword. So no tech, you know, when you created the atom bomb, it gave you nuclear fusion and atomic power, but at the same time it gave you a weapon of mass destruction. So there no technological invention of any kind is good or bad. It's just how you use it and how society is affected by it. Same is true with this whole Wiki Lambda, Wiki Data, Wiki functions, abstract Wikipedia issue.
If I could just add an analogy, okay? So abstract Wikipedia, basically it's like HTML. It's like a markup language kind of thing, okay? So it says like what kind of content needs to be shown to the user, all right? And then you have different browsers that use different rendering engines, right? Like Chrome, Firefox and all, they have their own rendering engines, which takes this markup and displays it on the screen in a nice way with different colors and all that thing, right? And this kind of the browser that you use uses the engine, and it can show it on different kinds of screens, different kinds of operating systems. But the source is that HTML markup code, okay? And then it will use some library from somewhere, okay? So this markup text is like the abstract Wikipedia, all right? And the engine which kind of takes that and puts it in a nice this thing, makes it presentable, puts it in a table and everything, and shows it to you visually, is like the Wiki function. So that Wiki function will be different for each language. If you have Wiki functions for your language, you can show the abstract Wikipedia in your language. This is a bit of an analogy for tech, which techies will understand actually. Sorry again to one.
Which I'm the only one here. I don't, okay, I'm being a bit dismissive here.